Last year, the Algonquin football team went to the Central Mass Super Bowl, a great accomplishment. But the Teahawks aren't satisfied. They want to do even better this year.
I wouldn't say we look at it as pressure, but anything less is obviously not there. So everyone's goal right now is to get there and to win that game and to get even farther. So we're starting now, and hopefully we'll get there. But that's the goal.
I think that's a standard we set, and that's where we want to be. We want to build from that, actually. And right now, we're just all about getting wins and getting better for our first game.
And Algonquin taking on North at Foley Stadium, and that will be their first game. Last year, Grafton got to Gillette Stadium in the state championship. The Indians have huge numbers in camp this year, and it translates to good depth and competition, making each other better every day.
Stars this year, but I think there's just raw talent throughout the entire 11 of us. We're all going to have to play as a team. You know, we've always have, and we always will. It's what it's going to have to take this year to win.
It's intense. I mean, we got 77 guys out here every day working really hard, competing for their jobs. I mean, no one's guaranteed a spot yet, so you have to work really hard to earn it.
We got to come out. We have to practice hard every day. We have to push each other. Scouts got to push the starters, and they got to fight for positions to make everyone work harder.
And Grafton will open their season taking on North Middlesex. They've already had good scrimmages against Doherty and St. Peter Marion. Speaking of the Doherty football team, they compete at the highest division in Central Mass, the only inter-high team in Division II. Now, the Highlanders take a lot of pride in representing not only their school, but their entire city playing at the highest level.
I mean, being in the top division and the only inter-high school with the school that's in there means a lot to us. I mean, showing what we can do, because the inter-high gets a bad name sometimes, and it's nice for us to be able to show us that the inter-high can play with everyone.
Well, I mean, we're pretty known around Worcester as the best inter-high team, and we like to keep it that way. So we like to compete with whatever team we play with, whoever we play with, and wherever we play with.
You know, we have pride in playing in this heart of division. I think, honestly, we're up for it. We're actually going for the champ this year.
All right, so Doherty will open up their season, taking on Wachusett Thursday night, September the 7th, in a game you can see live right here on Charter TV 3. In society, too many people get hung up on wins and losses in high school sports and forget what sports are really supposed to be about at that level, teaching life lessons. Now, while the Burncoat football team's goals are to win, head coach Rick Sincotta is thinking long-term with his players.
Win, win, win. But you know what? It's not only do we want to win, we want to get better because we're rebuilding the program. We have a lot of young players, a lot of sophomores and freshmen coming up that are stepping up. We have a lot of good players coming up that are young, and all we got to do is get them on the right track, and we're going to be an outstanding program this year.
Number one goal is to put together a winning program. That's what we want from varsity all the way down to our freshmen. So we want to build a strong program that's making progress, that's being successful, not only on the field but in the classroom. We want to send kids off to college. We want to make sure that they're getting their education after they leave Burncoat High School.
All right, Rick Sincotta doing a great job with that Burncoat squad, and they're looking good. Numbers are up. A lot of competition in camp for the Patriots. Coming up on Friday, it is the high school football preview show, as we will break down all of the divisions in Central Massachusetts. Andy Lacombe and I will give you our picks, our predictions for the season, making friends and making enemies all at once. That is this Friday night at 10:30 p.m. So that'll be exciting. Then college football season kicks off. Holy Cross at UConn. That one going to be really exciting right now. Holy Cross is healthy. They have a lot of fifth-year seniors, four on the offensive side of the ball. So this is their year to really break out, and it starts taking on a tough FBS team. So great test right out of the gate for the Crusaders.
It's good stuff. They got all the kids back at school.
Yeah.
It's going to be a big tailgate, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. They're running fan buses down there to UConn, and it is a good scene out there. There's a lot of land all around the stadium, so there is a good tailgating scene out there.
Good stuff. Looking forward to it.
Yep.
Well, that's going to do it for us here on Worcester News Tonight. For Kevin Shea, I'm Anna Botari. We'll see you guys tomorrow.